Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2395. How to do ceiling or floor in Power Query. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. For me, this is really doing MROUND up or MROUND down. But for whatever reason, it's not called MROUND up or down. It's called CEILING.MATH. All right, so if you have like a number 40 and you want to round it to the nearest 25, it's always going to round up. So 40 goes to 50, even 26, just something just barely over 25 is still going to round up to 50. Like, how many cases do we have to order? If you need 26 and there's only 25 per case, you need two cases. And going the other way, to always round down, floor.math. The number 40 to the nearest 25 will go down to the 25. Even 49.999 returns 25. But this all gets complicated when your number is negative. If you're sitting at negative 57 and you want to go to the higher 25, what is that? Some people would say that's negative 75, but negative 75 is less than negative 57. So the mathematicians would say the right answer is negative 50. Now, it's interesting. In the old days, ceiling and floor went the wrong way. And when they introduced ceiling.math and floor.math, they always went in the correct direction. But they added an optional mode argument that could force it to go in the wrong direction, right? So the ceiling.math of minus 57, we're going to the higher number, will be negative 50. But if you add this mode argument, it will go the wrong way. The ceiling will go down towards negative 75. All right, same thing with floor.math. You can control whether it goes down or up, depending on whether you use the mode. All right, so here's the four functions that we have in Excel. Ceiling.math, ceiling.math with a mode of 1, floor.math, and floor.math with a mode of 1. And the question is, can we replicate those in Power Query? And yes, we can, but you're going to have to do it with a custom column. All right, so here for each of the four formulas in Excel, here's the equivalent formula in Power Query. To enter these, you're going to go to the Add column and say that you want a custom column. Let's take a look at one of these that I created. You'll give it a name, PQ ceiling, and then equal number dot round up, and reusing the number and the multiple. There you have it, kind of the Rosetta Stone of these various functions in Excel and how to do the same thing in Power Query. Hey, check out my new book, Mr. Excel 2021, Unmasking Excel. Click that I in the top right-hand corner for more information. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments in the YouTube comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.